This isn't the view everywhere, but Frederick's been one of the soggiest locations, so you can still see that fresh rainfall across the Westview Promenade this afternoon. And other spots have seen a little more dry time, so a lot of that fresh rainfall has been able to dry up a little bit. Nonetheless, it is a damp one as we go throughout this Wednesday afternoon, and it's likely that that trend is going to keep continuing, at least for the next little while anyway here as we continue along. Visibility has improved quite a bit from this morning when we had the rainfall and some residual cloud cover and fog, but now really just across Frederick County, we're still seeing those lowered visibilities. And of course, as you head further east, that's where the rainfall is still situated this afternoon. And check it out here. Yep, steady rainfall pushed through the area. A lot of that has drifted north, but look at how it's starting to build back to the west just a little bit. So we're by no means done with this rainfall as of yet, but many of us are seeing drier conditions, especially back across the eastern panhandle, western Maryland, and the I-81 corridor through northern Virginia. It's again back to the east, mostly along and east of I-95, where that rain is still pretty steady. So through Montgomery County, Frederick County, and a little bit there into Loudoun and Fairfax County, that's where the rainfall is still continuing. So it's going to remain pretty damp out there, and we'll still have that rain possible to the east, at least through the evening time. Then we're due for our next round of rainfall after a brief dry period on Thursday night with yet another system rolling our direction. And we're going to see those temperatures staying on the very warm side of things until we see that system move through and we pick up those wind speeds quite a bit on Friday. It's likely we could see some high wind warnings potentially as we wrap up this week. But for now, we're still tracking that rainfall out there. Again, if the further east you go, you're a lot more likely to run into that rainfall. It could push as far west again as I-81, but most of the western half of the viewing area is going to just stay cloudy and dry. But nonetheless, that rain gets out of here by the 5 to 6 o'clock hour. We're looking at fairly cloudy and warm conditions tonight with a little bit of clearing possible as we go throughout the day on Thursday. But nonetheless, it's short-lived as that next system begins to roll in late on Thursday. We could see a few showers very early in the overnight, but most of the rain will be occurring late on Thursday night, continuing all the way into your Friday morning as well. So that's the setup for the rest of the day today. More rain to the east. We'll hold a shower chance further west, but it looks like we're mostly done with the rainfall as you head back into the higher elevations. And tomorrow is dry, but with all of this rainfall building to the south and west, we'll start to see that making a return late Thursday and going all the way into Friday. And with that, temperatures will be up into the 70s very easily through the end of the week. We do start to cool back down a bit as we roll toward next Monday.